Just as an aside, I'd like to actually show you an interesting example of what would be an ideal focal length for taking images of portraits. Again, I have my scene, I have my camera. I can use an 85mm lens and get the whole field of view that I want. In this case, I'm using a simple example, a bust of Abraham Lincoln. I'm using this 85mm lens, and this is what the shot I get. I move closer. This is a 50mm lens, now looking at the same subject. Here is the output. It does get darker a little bit for a variety of reasons. We'll be looking at that in more detail when we talk about the exposure triangle. But you notice that there is a little bit of a difference between these two images, right? If I was to just basically say this lips here seem to be now much more smaller in this one. But actually, let's go in further and see if we can move further and see what happens. Moving the camera further in, since I want the same field of view, I would, of course, I have the same sensors, the same camera, I would have to change the focal length. This is what telephoto lenses are usually very good at. And of course, now you see a 20mm lens, and this is the image we get. If you notice, this face now has a little bit more distortion. It feels more curved and much more kind of all things, the dimensions seem to be, and the dimensions have shrunk a little bit. The nose seems a little bit more a kind of projected outwards, as opposed to, in this case, the face looks much more face-like. So here, there is a lot more distortion. Now, of course, most photography is, you know, again, what you want to do with it. But just by changing these types of things or parameters on your camera, you can change the look and feel of an image. So traditionally, most portrait lenses that people use are 75mm to 135. I actually prefer to use an 85mm. This is one of my favorite lenses because it actually gives you portrait. And of course, there are other things that are going on that we'll also look at is, you know, issues around a little bit of more blurring in the background, which is less kind of visible in these ones, but much nicer in these kind of an image. So in the next lecture, when we look at the exposure triangle, we'll be looking at the relationship of, again, details that allow us to kind of also get more information, the back and the front of an image.